What's up guys, hope you are all doing well. A few months ago, I've done a video about VRay Quick Settings and how to use it, and many of you liked that video. I've received a lot of positive comments about how easy to use VRay Quick Settings and how much time they saved. If you haven't seen that video and you want to learn how to use VRay Quick Settings, you can check it from the link in the video description. Unfortunately, in VRay 5, they removed VRay Quick Settings icon from the VRay toolbar. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to add it to VRay toolbar in a very fast and easy way. So without further ado, let's start. First thing to do, let's open 3ds Max and go to the VRay toolbar. If you can't see VRay toolbar, just right click on the viewport layout tabs and select VRay toolbar. Now let's click on the VRay toolbar, right click and then select customize. Now go to toolbars and select from the category VRay. Scroll down until you see quick VRay render settings. Just drag it and drop it to the VRay toolbar. And that's it. Open it. Now let's do a quick render using it. Let's select interior from the presets. And let's change the GI quality to something like 25. Let's increase the shading quality to 50. And let's increase the anti-aliasing quality to 40. And as you can see, if we change anything from the VRay Quick Settings, it's automatically changed in the render setup. Now let's hit render. Now this is our render. Let's adjust it a little bit. Let's use the filmic tone map, which is the new feature in VRay 5. Let's play a little bit with the parameters. We can also add lens effect. So this is before post-processing and this is after. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you have enjoyed it and find it useful. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any upcoming videos. Thank you and see you in the next video. Bye.